This retreat is for 1 week. Everyone should get a copy of this, either in Vietnamese or in English. In Vietnamese, it's called Kung Fu. Kung Fu means daily practice. It's not martial art. There are 7 columns, one for Monday, one for Tuesday, and so on. And then in the evening, before you go to sleep, you have to look and you evaluate the practice. Your practice. You evaluate the day of practice that is ending. Waking up. When you wake up, do you practice? Do you know that you are waking up on the mountains in a retreat? Are you able to smile? You know, to realize that you are in a retreat, this is a great opportunity. And if this morning you did not do that, you were not happy, you were not aware that you woke up in a retreat on the mountain with the Sangha, and then you put a zero here. And you are welcome to grade, I think, from 1 to 90. Because from 90 to 10, we reserve it for the fully enlightened ones. Our humility. Sometimes we feel that we are very close to 100%, but it's still practicing humility. We just put 90. Let's take practice. Waking up, you are able to smile and to value, to remember that you have a brand new 24 hours to live. What a gift. And if you wake up without that kind of awareness, that is a waste. So this morning, if you did not practice that, if you waking up did not have any value, just give it zero. And then wearing your shoes. Because wearing your shoes mindfully can bring you a lot of happiness. Wearing your shoes is not only for walking. Wearing your shoes is for wearing your shoes like washing the dishes. Washing dishes is not only for having clean dishes, but the time of washing dishes can be joyful. You can dwell in the here and the now, in the kingdom of God, during the time of dishwashing. And every bowl you wash, every dish you wash is like, it's as sacred as you are giving the newborn baby Buddha a bath. It's very sacred. If mindfulness and concentration is there, everything becomes sacred, holy. Because the energy of mindfulness, the energy of concentration, is the energy of holiness. So your holiness has to wash your bowl mindfully. Otherwise, you are not holy at all. And mindfulness and concentration, that is substance of mindfulness, of holiness. When I was when I first became a novice, my teacher gave me a book of about 50 verses to memorize, to practice mindfulness. And there is one for wearing your shoes. In my case, not leather shoes, but wood clock. Yeah. And then sitting in your bed, and you use your leg to find out your slipper, your shoes. You breathe in and out, and you recite silently the verse. It's like this. Tùng triêu dần đáng trực chi mộ, nhất thiết chúng sanh từ hồi hộ, nhược ư tán hạ, nhược ư túc hạ tán kỳ hình, nguyện nhữ tức thời sanh tịnh độ. That's what I learned when I was 16. From the morning until the late evening, every living being has to take care of himself or herself. If by chance, if by bad chance, I step on you, one of you, and crush you under my feet, I wish that you be born right away into the Pure Land of the Buddha. I was so moved. That is the practice of compassion and mindfulness. You know that while walking, you cannot avoid killing little creatures. And that is why finding your seat, you are aware of that. You want to preserve, to protect the life of living beings. And that adverse help you to create, to generate the energy of mindfulness, and also to cultivate compassion. So while wearing your shoes, please enjoy your practice. The practice is not only in a meditation hall. And make sure that you are happy and solid and joyful during the time of wearing your shoes. And then if you do well, and then you can write down a note like a 60, 80, 90. Otherwise, you give a zero. No one will look into your Kung Fu book. You and the Buddha within yourself, both of you, take care of that. We never inquire about you or about this. This is not an exam. And you and the Buddha and you are enough. The Dharma teacher may have the right to ask, do you practice it? I just, yes, that's it, good enough. He doesn't have to look into it. But he has to make sure that you do it. Folding your blanket, opening the door, closing the door. You know my story of closing the door? One day, my teacher told me to go and do something for him. I love him so much, I was very eager to go and do it for him, that I closed the door after me, not mindfully. He called me back. My child, yes. Go out again and close the door mindfully. This time, I understood. He never had to teach me again a second time. I knew how to close the door mindfully. From that moment. And when I met Thomas Merton in 1966, in his Kentucky monastery, I told him that. He remembered very well. And he spoke about it in a Dhamma talk, in his Christian Dhamma talk. And it happens that a Catholic lady living in Germany had listened to that talk by Thomas Merton. And she was very curious. That is why she went to Plum Village to see how Thầy closed the door. She did not tell us. She just came and signed up for 1 week. And the purpose is to observe. But after 1 week, she stayed on for another 2 weeks. She loved it. And then on the day she departed, during the steam meditation, we asked her to tell her feeling, and she told us the story, why she had come. She was just curious to see how Thầy closed the door behind him. And she had been observing all of us during 3 weeks. So, closing the door, opening the door, is a practice. You have to do it in the kingdom of God, in the Pure Land of the Buddha. And if you are inhabited by the energy of mindfulness and concentration, you can be very happy closing the door. Not because you don't want to make noise for other people, but the main purpose is to be always in the Pure Land of the Buddha. Going to the WC, defecating, washing your hand, brushing your teeth, washing your face, looking in the mirror, smile with compassion. And you have a list like this. Turning on the light. You need only 1 second in order for the light to be. In many areas of the earth, where you have to go for the lamp, you have to strike a match. It takes more time. And sometimes there's no match. Taking a shower. The water flows. You become aware that the water has come from far away, deep in the earth, or very high on from the mountains. And the miracle and the water running on your fingers is a miracle. From time to time, I take some water and wash my eyes. And I value each drop of water like a pearl, like a jewel. It's wonderful, the water. And happiness is made of these moments of mindfulness. The practice can be described as the practice of mindfulness. Mindfulness made of concentration, and happiness is made of concentration and mindfulness. And when you are happy, when you have energy of mindfulness and concentration, you feel good within yourself. You feel that you are in the kingdom of God. And you are in a situation to help other living beings. You no longer complain of anything because you have enough compassion to embrace and to help other living beings. So please get a copy of this